accepted.
So before we get started here, let's take a quick look at what we're actually going to make. So this is the second version of our PHP source code analyzer. And let's take a look at the output. So you can see the output is very similar to the last version, but a little bit different. So let's start coding. Okay, here we go. So over here on the left, we have the first version of the script that we created. And then over here on the right is the new version that we're going to be creating. Hey guys, I just wanted to let you know real quick that I'm putting on a live Python workshop. Now in this workshop, I'm going to be teaching you how to create surveillance tools using Python. Now this workshop will not be posted to my YouTube channel. And on top of that, I'm only going to allow a limited number of people into the live workshop. So if you're a beginner or you're experienced, this workshop is for you. Now, if you want to get in on this, click the link down in the description or click the link on the video above. All right, guys, let's get back to coding. So let's analyze this code. So starting off, we create our list. And in this list, you can see we declare an item for each one of our if statements. Well, not necessarily our if statements, but actually each one of the functions that we're going to be searching for as we analyze each line of a PHP source code file. Okay, so we have our list declared. That's great, that's awesome. It's going to clean up all this crap we got going on over here. So let's jump in to our new function. So you can see it's a little bit different. So we start out by declaring the C variable. This is going to keep track of which line of the PHP file we're currently analyzing. The second variable, t, will keep track of how many times we find a potentially vulnerable function. So basically, each time we find one of these, we'll add one to that. And we're going to use that in the output down here below. All right, so next is the line that's just going to open the source code file that we're analyzing. And now next, what we're going to do is we're going to loop through each line of that file. And each line will get stored into this variable right here called line. Imagine that. All right, next we're going to add one to our variable C because we are now analyzing the first line of the PHP file. And we can do that by using this plus equal statement, which is basically the same thing as doing C plus, C plus one. So instead of doing that, we can just do this and it's the same thing. Yay. Okay, so moving on. This is the bread and butter that does all the magic for our new routine. This is what's going to clean up all this over here and kind of reduce it down to pretty much just this one line. Function, or I don't know what the heck you'd actually call it, the proper terminology. Yeah, I guess it'd be function. So this any function is kind of unique in Python. I haven't ever used something like this in any other language. But all right, so basically what this does is kind of allows you to iterate through two different lists and find any true statements. Or how we're using is basically if any of these items are within our line, then true. And if true, then we're going to run this code. So hopefully that makes sense. And if not, just leave any questions in the comments and I'll be happy to help you out. But basically what this is doing is allowing us to kind of clean up some of our code. Instead of doing basically multiple for loops, we can just kind of put this all into one line as well as doing kind of a comparison all at the same time. So it's kind of, I guess, three different statements kind of in one statement. So let's kind of walk through this. I think this might help kind of make sense of this. So we're going to open our file. And then once we open our file, we then hit our for loop. And this is what's going to loop through each line of the file. So the first time we go through, we're on the first line of the text. So right now, the value line is equal to the first line in the source code file that we're analyzing. So remember that. Now, when we get here, remember, we're going to kind of start over here on the right. We're not going to start on the left, but we're going to start on the right because we need to populate this F. Because we can't compare these two until we have a value in F. And right now, F is empty. So once we get here, we're going to go for F in find. So it's going to come up here, get the first element, and F is now going to equal include this element right here. So now that this is populated, it's then going to hop right over here, and then we're going to do this comparison. Now we're going to say if F is inside that first line from our PHP file, then true. And any says if true, well, then we're going to go on. So if this statement is true, then our code here will execute. However, if F is not in that line, well, then this will be false and this will not be executed. Again, if that doesn't make sense, hey, just leave some questions in the comments and I'll be happy to help you out. All right, so moving on. If this is true, if we did find one of these functions in our line of code, then what we want to do is we want to add 1 to our t value. And then we're going to print to the screen the line number that we're currently analyzing and the actual line of code that contained the potentially vulnerable function. And then it's going to come back up and it's going to get the next line of the source code file, increment C by 1, and it's going to do the same thing. And we're going to keep doing that until we finish looking at the entire file. All right, so once the file is complete, we'll now come to our footer message. And this is just a simple message that says we found X number of functions from X number of lines of code. And we just simply wrap the C and T variable inside the string function here. All right, so let's move on to the very last part, which is actually the beginning of our application. When our application is ran for the first, or not for the first time, but when the application is ran, it will begin here. And the very first thing we do is we export this header message. And then we're going to check to see if they supplied a source code file. If the user did not supply an argument and did not give a source code file, then we'll print this help message right here that says, hey, we need a source code file. This is what the command you need to execute. And then we'll go ahead and just close the program so they can execute the command properly. If they did provide the source code file, then we'll simply just pass that argument, as we do here, off to our function, which then gets the ball rolling. So that's it, guys. That is how, that is the new version of this source code analyzer script. And kind of gives you a basic, very basic introduction to lists. You can do a lot more with lists, like, you know, adding items and moving items and sorting and so on. And we'll get into that a little bit later as necessary or useful. But what I kind of want to get into is showing you guys some of the GUI capabilities of Python. Because it's cool to make command line scripts, those are nice, but it's also great to be able to make a GUI interface if you so desire. Sometimes certain programs are just more functional from a GUI, and sometimes certain programs are more functional from a command line. So I'm really excited to get into some of the GUI stuff because that's a new realm for me. And while it's fun, it's also frustrating. So I'll get to share all of that with you guys. All right, guys, that's going to do it for today, but I greatly appreciate you watching this video and sticking around. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like this video. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe now. That way you'll get an update next time I post a new video. And as always, I will see you on the other side. Login accepted.